Good morning, children. This is our English literature period. Today we are going to start lesson 9. That means today we are going to read story The Secret Garden. Before I tell you the story, I want you to get familiar with the characters of this story. She is Mary Lennox, who is very selfish, rude and lonely girl. She is a little girl. Servant Martha. She is a very kind lady and she loves to laugh. His brother Deacon, who is very kind and friendly person, and he is an animal lover. Gardener Ben. Uncle Craven. Okay, now a very important character of the story, little bird Robin. So here you can see the characters we are going to meet in this story. Okay, so children, this story is about a small little girl. Who lost her parents and shifted to her Uncle Craven's place. Okay, she was very selfish, rude and lonely because she was neglected by her parents. Who was neglected? Mary Lennox was neglected by her parents. So this is the reason behind her rudeness and selfishness. Is it clear, children? So here the secret garden changed her life completely. After her parents' death, she was shifted to her Uncle Craven's place. Then her life was changed. And how her life was changed? Because of the secret garden. Now we will see in the story how secret garden helped Mary to change her life. Now let's start story. There was a girl named Mary Lennox who was living in India with her parents. She was neglected by her unloving parents and spoiled by her servants. But unfortunately, due to cholera epidemic, she lost her parents. She is an orphan. After her parents' death, she was sent to live with her uncle, Mr. Craven. She felt alone and scared on the first day in Misselthwaite Manor. Children, Misselthwaite Manor are old big houses. Houses with 100 rooms. She was feeling alone and scared at her uncle's place. Why? Because she was not knowing anybody there. Everybody is stranger for her at her uncle's place. That is why she was feeling alone and scared. One of her uncle's servant, Martha, who was a kind and friendly person, appointed to take care of Mary. She came to Mary's room to wake her up, but Mary did not like Martha. You know why? Because Martha refused to dress Mary and she encouraged her to be more independent, and she used to teach her to do her work on her own. And Mary didn't like this, as she was dependent on her servants in India and she was surrounded by cross people, means angry people. Why people were angry on her? Because she used to show lot of tantrum. Okay, let's see what happens. Martha felt that Mary was a rude and strange child. But actually, somewhere she was feeling sorry for her because she was able to understand that why Mary is so rude. Martha always tried to make Mary comfortable. So she told all about her family and her brother Jacob. Her brother Jacob was 12 years old and who could talk to birds and animals, as he was animal lover. He was a kind and friendly boy. Other than this, Martha told Mary about Manor's beautiful gardens. She also told her about the secret garden, which is locked and nobody has permission to go inside. Mary was surprised to hear this and she wanted to know reason. So she asked Martha for the reason. Martha told her that her uncle Craven locked it 10 years ago when he lost his wife. It was his wife's garden and he won't allow anyone to go inside. So he locked the door and hid the key. Now Mary was very much curious, you know, about the secret garden. She wanted to see that secret garden. Now she wanted to meet her uncle Craven, but somewhere she knew that her uncle would not lie. One day when Mary was exploring the garden, she saw a little bird, Robin. Little bird, Robin, sitting on the tree and singing sad song. Mary felt as if bird was calling her. She was feeling depressed, but this bird Robin made her feel much better and she started enjoying the Robin's company. She thought Robin lives in the secret garden and it must be knowing everything about the garden. Next few days, Mary spent her time wandering around the garden and she was trying to find out the key of the secret garden, as she was very much interested in that garden. She wanted to know everything about that garden. And finally, one day, you know what happened? She got that key. She got what she was looking for. She got the key of the secret garden. Now she was really excited and looked for the door under the dense creeper that covered the wall. She got the door and opened it. She looked behind her to make sure that nobody is watching her. She entered garden and shocked. It was difficult to believe that finally she was in garden. She was standing inside the garden and it was strangest place Mary had ever seen, because the whole garden was dead. Plants were brown and looked dead. Maybe because of winter season. It was horrible garden, as that was very obvious because it was neglected from the edges. There was a robin bird who was sitting there. Mary and Robin started moving in the garden. Bird Robin wanted Mary to see everything in the garden. Mary did not realize she came far away from the manor, but you know what, children? She was not scared. She was not feeling lonely because she had found a little world of her own. When she was roaming in the garden, She spots some green shoots on the ground, and this gives her hope of life, hope that garden is not completely dead, that garden is not dead, there is life. She was really happy that day. That day, she ate more than she had ever eaten. Martha was surprised to see this change. After that, Mary used to go regularly in the garden and started working on it, pulling and cutting dead plants and clearing every inch of the garden. Mary was not having much idea about gardening, so she asked Martha to help her, and Martha asked her brother Deacon to help Mary. Now Deacon begins helping Mary in the secret garden. Very soon they became good friends. Deacon assured her that if they work hard, they save the secret garden. They can save the secret garden. After that day, both friends started spending time in the garden, planting seeds and working away with the little robin giving them company. Their hard work started paying them back. Flowers and roses had come alive. Even the plants which grew on the wall had become green. The garden was beautiful and blooming. Because of this beautiful result, even after working so hard, Mary never felt tired. And you know, children, what? The beauty of the hard work and the smell of the fresh earth had made her strong. Now the little cross, angry girl transformed into a new person. She became healthier and happier after spending most of her time in the garden. And you know what? She made new friends. Deacon, Martha and Gardener Ben. It seemed as if all the unkindness, sorrow of her past life vanished because of the beauty, peace and calmness she found in the secret garden. The selfish girl becomes kinder, more careful and outgoing, who was always ready to help everybody around her. You know what, children, if we utilize our negative energy in constructive work, it gives us positivity. Constructive work helps our negative energy to transform into positive energy. It is not important to involve in gardening only. You can do anything constructive. You can do painting. You can decorate something, you can cook something, whatever you like, wherever you feel happy, you can utilize your negative energy in a positive work, in a constructive work, so that the negativity of your life, you know, can vanish and you can fill with positive energy. So this is how the nature, the mother nature, helped the little girl to change her life and make her beautiful and kind person. So this is all about the story, children. Thank you so much for listening.